From News 8 WMTW-TV, this is a News 8 Now update.
You're watching News 8 Now. I'm Shannon Moss.
I'm Norm Karkos. The Maine Heritage Policy Center is threatening to sue the city of Portland if councilors do not change a taxi ordinance that councilors passed just last week.
And that ordinance essentially put a college student right out of business. Matt Rand used a golf cart to operate a free taxi service on Peaks Island. News 8's Dave Guthrow is at Portland City Hall to tell us more about these latest developments.
Well, if you're ever spending time on Peaks Island during the summer, there's a good chance that you've seen Matt Rand at work. The 19-year-old from Cape Elizabeth uses his personal golf cart to taxi people while they're coming off the ferry around Peaks Island. Now, he doesn't have a set rate that he charges, but he does accept tips. The only other taxi service on the island is city-subsidized and, in fact, does have a set rate. They were complaining because Rand wasn't insured or licensed, and a new ordinance that was passed last week forced him to finally do so. Peaks Island Transportation is a nonprofit group that spent around $25,000 in city money for a van and insurance last year and claimed that Rand should have to do the same. Well, now the Maine Heritage Policy Center is threatening to sue the city of Portland unless it changes that new ordinance and allows Rand to continue his golf cart taxi service. They claim that the ordinance itself is preventing Rand from going to work and that it's aimed at eliminating the sole competitor to a city-subsidized service. And the Policy Center has scheduled a news conference for later on this morning here in Portland. And we'll have full coverage of that tonight on News 8 at 6 and on WMTW.com. For now in Portland, I'm Dave Guthrow for News 8 Now.
Jury selection expected to begin today in the murder trial of Kenneth McDonald. He is accused of the stabbing and the beating death of his mother, Janice McDonald. A relative found her body at the home that they shared in Monmouth in August of last year. According to court documents, Mrs. McDonald died from multiple stab wounds to the face and neck. Jury selection is set this morning at Kennebec County Superior Court in Augusta. Westport Police asking for your help in finding a missing woman. Officers say 61-year-old Diane Sanders has not been seen since 11 o'clock yesterday morning when she left her group home on Chelsea Street there. She's about 5'3", 145 pounds with dark brown shoulder length hair. If you have any information about where she is, Westport Police would like to hear from you.
A steeple is back in place on the historic Damariscotta Baptist Church. Crowds came out to watch as a giant crane moved it back to where it belongs yesterday. Steeple had been grounded since 2007. Fundraising committee says they had to give up on reaching their $509,000 goal this year. But that was until 92-year-old Maxine Wright stepped in with a gift of $35,000.
Well, I lived here for over 35 years. The happiest years of my life. I wanted to say thank you to Dennis Carter.
Steeples tend to be targets because of their height. This one had been hit by lightning twice and caught fire in the 1940s.
Good story there.
It's a great story.
That's it for this update. I'm Norm Karkos.
And I'm Shannon Moss. Stay with us. We're going to bring the latest forecast. Just a hint, it's raining today. Sports highlights in a few minutes. We'll be right back.